Students, today we will be studying the first unit, hotel design consideration. As we very well know, there are many points which have to be kept in mind while designing any hotel. We will discuss today three points. First, attractive appearance. Second, good location. And third is efficient planning. So coming to the first point, attractive appearance. The face and facade of the hotel must be of superior quality. Like the design is in such a manner that the guests are motivated to come to that property. Rather, they are compelled to come to their property. The front must be of such a manner that it reflects the theme of the hotel, the hygiene standard of the hotel, and the overall standard of the hotel. We all very well know the guest, first thing the guest sees is the appearance. So maximum input is given to the face, to the facade, to the front, to the elevation of the hotel. And you can see this in practical example also. You pick up any hotel, you will see the appearance is of utmost superior quality, and because of that also only we are able to get to compel the customer to come to our property. Understood? So coming to the second point, good location. Again, as we very well know, we can take the example of Las Vegas. Las Vegas is a place which is a junction of many roads. Basically, we all know it is a desert area. But again, although it is a desert area, but the maximum number of casinos are there. The best property of the world are out there. Why it is so? It is just because of the location. The location plays very important role in designing any hotel. It is, as per my thinking, this is of utmost importance, because location only will decide the type of customer we will be having. Like if you want your customer of higher segment, obviously where you will go? You will go near airport or at posh location. Similarly, if you want to cater to the customers of humble background or of comparatively lower standard, then you will go near railway station. If you want your customer like if you want walk-in customers, then you will open your restaurant in the heart of the city, where there are picture halls, where there are shopping complex, where people come just for fun, just for walking, just for hangouts. Only then you will get walk-in customers. So whenever you are designing any hotel, you have to consider the clientele you are catering to, the type of customers that will be coming to your property, and the standard of customers or the guest which you want should come to your hotel. So this is good location, which you must always keep in mind while designing any hotel. Clear? Now we will be coming towards third point, efficient plan. Obviously, planning is everything. Without planning, what we can do? In facility planning, we learn how to ensure optimal utilization of the available resources. How can we understand this thing? We have to ensure that we can get the work done by minimum employees without getting them tired, and we also need maximum output out of these employees. How it is possible? It is possible only when there is efficient planning. Let us take a very simple example. We all know pickup area. From pickup area, service people will come, they will pick up the dishes and serve them to the various customers. We have to ensure that the pickup area and the restaurant are nearby only. Why nearby? Because that will ensure that minimum distance will have to be covered by the customer, by the service people, and the customer will get their order at the required temperature and in minimum time, obviously. Again, this will also ensure that our service people are not tired unnecessarily, which is very important because they have to work at longer duration. In longer duration, they have to work, maybe they have to work in longer shifts, and if they are tired, they won't be able to give their maximum productivity. So efficient planning will ensure that their productivity is maximum and their tiredness is minimum. Similarly, in kitchen, we have to ensure that all the chef will get proper work table as per their requirement. It should have proper drawers where they can keep their equipments. The range must be located in such a location that it is very comfortable to work over it. The water supply must be proper and the cleaning area must be at proper space where they can clean their various dishes or their various vegetables or other items without any lack of comfort. They can very comfortably do their cleaning job out there. They can wash their vegetables and other things. And we have to ensure that the range and the washing area must not be nearby. Otherwise, there may be chances of accidents that we do not want. Similarly, we have to see that the kitchen and store must be nearby. It should be nearby so that we can get the various items required in the kitchen easily, efficiently, comfortably. So these very little things, if we keep in mind while planning, while designing our hotel, we will see that we can have the maximum outcome. This is what you call in management optimal utilization of the available resources. Number of employees will be less, their productivity will be more, and also they are not tired unnecessarily. They will be in their comfort zone, and this will ensure the quality of our hotel. And obviously, if quality is good, revenue is good. If revenue is good, then everything is good. Everything depends upon the revenue. Revenue depends upon the service, and service depends upon efficient planning. And efficient planning, we are taking care in facility planning. So these things have to be dealt with very efficiently, very minutely. We have to keep in mind all the aspects which are required in any kitchen, in any restaurant, in any working area of the hotel, and we will see that efficiency will be increased manifold. I may ask you to think over it, the scope of improvement in the properties where you may have done your ITs or where you may have visited, and then you can share your thoughts, your videos in the comment section. Do give me feedback if you want anything else from me, any other examples, and if there is any query regarding these topic, these points, kindly give your comments in the comment section. And if it is possible, then we can use this platform to interact with the student community of the hotel management worldwide. We may get many new examples, we may get many new thought process, we may get very new in many new innovative ideas which we may have never thought of. So I may request you to give your suggestions, give your comments, give your example, give your inputs, give your anything which you have experienced in this field, in your hotel management field, and the scope of improvement which you may feel any particular organization can do. And we will be waiting for your comments, and tomorrow we will be taking up the remaining points of design consideration. Thank you. Thanks a lot for listening. Goodbye.